Hello everyone, welcome to the first video of Enoarchy's tutorial. So today we are going to look into some of the basic tools in Photoshop. Let's begin. For that we have to create a new page. I'm creating an A1 size page. So you can select with the orientation of the sheets and check on whether it is in centimeters or not. Yes, let's begin. The basic thing in the Photoshop is that we have to create a new layer by clicking on the layer icon in the layer style toolbar and check on whether the layer is locked or not. So yes, let's move on to the toolbar. You can find the toolbar at the left of your screen. So I'm going to drag the toolbar closer to the page for my convenience. Yes, so let's go on to the tools in the toolbar. The first one is the move tool. The move tool moves a selection or a layer. You can move the objects using the cursor, and also you can resize it by dragging it or change the position of the image responding to your freedom. So this is the use of the move tool. So moving on to the selection tools, rectangular marquee tool. So this tool, you can select a particular portion, copy paste it to a new layer. So the vision icon in the layer makes the layer visible. Okay. So for instance, if you want to hide that particular layer, you can do so by using the eye icon in the layer style toolbar. You can also copy paste the same image as many times you want. Okay. So let's make it simple. The rectangular marquee tool selects the objects in the rectangular position. Okay. The elliptical marquee tool selects the image in the elliptical position. So this is the difference between both the marquee tools. Moving on to the laser tools. Okay. So there are three types of laser tool: freeform laser tool, polygon laser tool, and magnetic laser tool. So first we are going to look into the magnetic laser tool. So this magnetic laser tool, it makes a selection by snapping to image edges, so commonly termed as an edge detection tool. Move my cursor closer to the sofa. So this tool actively snaps the outline of that particular object, so I'll be able to snap the outline of the object completely. Now we have selected the object, press enter followed by Control C and Control V, we'll be able to view that particular object in a new layer. The second one is the laser tool. So this is also called as the freeform laser tool. It makes freehand selection. It works if you can just click and drag around the outline. See, as I'm doing around that particular object, the outline without restricting to the edges. That is like freehand sketch. You can do it like a freehand sketch. Yes, now the same procedure is that click enter followed by Control C plus Control V to get the image in a new layer. Now you'll be able to get the image in a new layer, and this is also a type of selection tool. Moving on to the last one in laser tool, it is the polygonal laser tool. This polygonal laser tool creates straight edges selections. It is suitable for linear forms and objects. For instance, if I want to grab a pattern, I can do so by using the straight edge line selection. So after selecting, you can proceed with enter, continued by Control C plus Control V to view it in a new layer. Getting into the last set of selection tools, the quick selection tool. This tool makes a selection by finding and following the edges in an image. So for now, if I'm going to select all the whites, that is the windows, okay? I start off by selecting the first one, then pressing shift, I'll be able to select the other white areas. Since a quick selection tool helps to grab all those similar closed edges, once the selection is done, you can press Control C plus Control V and finish the selection of the white pattern alone in a new layer. That's now done for this tool. That is the quick selection tool we have done for it. Moving on to the next tool, that is the magic wand tool. So this magic wand tool selects similar colored image areas. So for instance, if I am selecting all the solid area, that is the white pattern, I start off by selecting one area, then the same like we did before, by pressing shift, I'm able to select all the other white areas. See, I'm not relieving the shift key, I'm just pressing the shift key and then selecting all the areas. If you're not pressing the shift key, you'll not be able to select the areas. So for example, if I want to change the color of the We'll try a new one, okay? For example, if I'm going to change the color of the white area to a shade of peach, I can do so by pressing the color square. That is, click on the square, choose the color, then press Alt plus Delete to apply. So now we got the transfer of color. So there's not a big difference between these tools, but most probably I will prefer a quick selection tool, since this allows us to select a portion of the image more accurately. Whereas if you can see in Magic Wand tool, it won't work perfectly in just one click for complex structures. So finally, we have arrived to the end of our part 1 tutorial. A small recap on the tools we discussed. The move tool and moving on to the selection tools, we discussed on marquee tools, that is a rectangular marquee tool, elliptical marquee tool, and on the laser and the types of laser tools, we saw three types of laser tools. There's the magnetic laser tool, freeform laser tool, polygonal laser tool, and moving on to the final tools is the quick selection tool and the magic wand tool. So these are the selection tools in Photoshop. So we have completed with our selection tools. Let's catch up in the next video. So do follow and subscribe our channel for more interesting and helpful tutorials, so you can write out some informative source from our channel. Thank you. Bye.